Okay, this should be taught in universities, okay? This is how you clip form correctly. You're gonna take your long form content that you shot on YouTube, clip it up the best parts, and post it on your short form content side of social media via your Instagram, your TikTok, or YouTube Shorts. And I'm gonna show you exactly how to do it because this video is gonna be jam-packed with not only the best information, the most helpful information, but also the most entertaining video you'll probably ever watch on YouTube. So you're gonna subscribe and like the video. So first thing we're gonna do when we wanna clip farm is we wanna go to our previous video that we posted on YouTube, which is right here. So this is already edited, it's already got sound effects, so we're gonna put it in a separate file. We're gonna put it in a separate kind of import style. So I want this.
I've eaten in 9 hours. Think about that, you sleep, you're fasting. You know what I'm talking about? So I fast, but in my sleep.
Perfect, okay, so I recorded this on my phone, so we're just gonna go on another side and we're just gonna create a new project and find that inside of the phone from my desktop.
Shout out Gorilla Mind though. It is currently 1:30 in the afternoon. I woke up super early. I got like 4 hours of sleep, took a nap, refueled basically, had like my 5 eggs, some sourdough bread. It's good. I woke up with some purpose because the previous video that I'm editing into short form, the algorithm just fucking swooped it up like a tornado and it made me feel good. I'm like, nice, okay. This progress is meaning something. I'm doing something and I can legit see the progress and legit see that it's actually working. All right, we're about to cook up right here because I just airdropped it from my phone straight to my laptop and now we're gonna cook. I wanna put it in a little time lapse and just watch me work my magic because this is gonna go viral right here. It's literally just a question of how long can you keep posting? How consistent can you keep being? If the answer is a very long time, well then there you have it. You're gonna be successful. But if you just try it once and say, oh, YouTube algorithm is dead, this and that, chances are you haven't tried long enough to actually see any progress pay off. Once you see that little bit of progress, you're gonna be fucking hooked, bro. Imagine you go to the gym, right? And then you find that bicep vein, or you find that shoulder striation. Are you gonna stop going to the gym because you're winning now? Fuck no. This is just literally just the troubleshooting of being creative, right? Like if you truly don't like your product, you truly don't like the end game of what you made, just start over or just take a break. Just walk away from your laptop, do a few push-ups, go eat a meal or something, and then literally just come back to it, right? Like if you don't like what you're producing, why are you gonna release it? Literally just like let yourself cook, you know what I'm saying? Let yourself do what you need to do and then come back. And then you're fine. Then you just created a masterpiece. So we're gonna try it again. But I really like that clip. I'm gonna try to go a little longer with it. I'll show you guys the end product, what I got, post it. It's gonna get some engagement from my short form side to my long form side. I'm excited. Damn, I lost track of time. And that's what happens when I'm in editing mode. I just get lost in time and I get so creative to where like, oh, I could add this, I could add this. My brain just like turns off and I just, you know, literally lock in. So that was about an hour to edit a 21 second long video that I'm actually pretty proud of and I'll show you in a minute. But here's the thing. If the video doesn't get a lot of views, it really doesn't matter because I don't wanna destroy what I'm creating with all of this perspective of, oh, what I'm doing isn't worth it. It's all about the progress you're making, even if you don't see it, right? Because eventually you will. So you don't wanna discourage yourself of saying, oh, my Instagram reel only got 200 views, oh my God. Because I guarantee if that Instagram reel got 100,000 views, you wouldn't stop making videos. If you can change your view and your viewpoint to saying, okay, when I'm editing these videos, I am getting better little by little. So the more I do it, the more volume I put in, the more rewards I'm gonna get out later. Not now because I'm not good enough. I don't have the skill sets of editing yet, right? It's gonna take a long time. But if you enjoy it the way I do, then it's not work. It's literally just progress. Every time I edit a new video, short form or long form, I'm getting better every single time. So it doesn't matter if I get views or not. You have to do at least long form or stick to just purely short form. Because the way I do it, I can feed off both. If I do the long form content, I can just pick the greatest part, like this part, and then edit it up, put some captions in, put some stuff in the background, put sound effects, put music in the background, and it'll show up on your Instagram Reels or your YouTube Short or your TikTok For You page. And you'll be like, huh, I've seen this guy before on my page. I'm going to check out his YouTube channel. Because if you just see me one time, you're probably going to be like, I don't even know who this guy is. But if you repeatedly see me, then you're going to want to check me out. Just keep progressing. If you enjoy it and you're attached to it on an emotional level, you won't quit. Like, I won't quit because I enjoy making these videos. If I didn't enjoy making these videos and I was just headed for the money, I was just headed for the fame, I would have quit a very long time ago. But just seeing that one of my videos hit 400 views just organically on YouTube, my last video that I'm editing for my short form, it's just showing you that, like, hey, you're doing a good job. Here is the video that I made.
Because it is my first meal. I haven't eaten in 9 hours. Think about that. You sleep. You're fasting. So I fast, but in my sleep. It's so good because ketosis. I fast in my sleep, okay? But when I wake up, I'm getting fucking fuel. I need some fucking energy. I need fuel. I need fuel to fuel my workouts. That's all I'm going to say about that.
So yeah, that's the video. It took me about an hour for about 21 seconds. But like you see in the last clip that I made, I didn't like the original turnout of the first time I edited it. Because I was like, why am I going to create something that I'm not proud of that I'm literally just going to fucking half-ass and just release, right? Like, that's not how you go viral. That's not how you actually become successful. Like, take pride in your work, bro. It's either you're all in or all out. All or nothing. Like, especially with me, like, I want to make good quality stuff because I want people to watch my stuff and keep coming back. Like, return customers. It's just like a business, right? If you had a sandwich shop and you made bad sandwiches, chances are people aren't going to fucking come back. If you have a good product, like the content or the sandwich, people are going to keep coming back because they're going to enjoy what you made. So if you can convey your content in not only in an educational way, but an entertaining way where people keep tuning in to see what you learned and see what you know so they can put it in their day-to-day practices, then you kind of achieved what you need to achieve. Sometimes, like, I just get a creative, just brainstorm. Just a creative wave comes over me where I'm like, I'm gonna add this way, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that. Oh, I'm gonna add caption there, I'm gonna do this. And I literally just cook. It's what I call the flow state, where you just get in a state of mind where you literally are just cooking. But to get to a flow state, not only do you have to have the discipline to be like, okay, I'm gonna sit down right here and I'm gonna do this, but have an emotional attachment to it to where, like, I actually want to do this because I want to do this. I'm not doing it because I need the money or, you know, I need the fame. I need the engagement. I'm going to lose my consistent every single day posting streak. It's like, it's not like that. You're not going to stay consistent. You're going to burn out. I've had this so many times where you burn out because you feel obligated to, if you miss a day, you just completely ruined everything. You won't. Do it when you want to do it, bro. Like, if you enjoy doing it, put that love in like a jar and just seal it and just put it on the shelf. And then when you want to come back to it, open that fucking jar and start eating from it. And then once you do that, just fucking put it in a pot and just start cooking. And then make it into a meal that everyone can enjoy. I know you like my analogies. This is going a lot. This is basically like, this isn't even clip farming. This is literally just like the philosophy of content creation. And through my eyes, I'm not successful. I'm not a big content creator. I'm trying to be because I literally enjoy this. And if I could do this as a job, this would be the world to me, bro. Because like I said, I keep coming back to, if I can help people and inform them and educate them and entertain them all together, that would mean the world to me, bro. Like, if people can just watch me, yeah, I'm goofy sometimes. Yeah, I'm educational sometimes. Yeah, I'm serious sometimes. You don't know what to expect, and that's good. But I hope you like the guide to clip farming from long form content to short form, and kind of the philosophy, my philosophy of content creation and actually wanting to help people in one big kind of barrel. So hope you guys like that. Till next time, huh?